Members of the Herd, what is up? Hope you're having a fantastic day. Today I'm just going to answer a couple questions that I get a lot, which is what is my M1A build? I'm also going to do my SKS build, try to get those up as quickly as possible. I'm not only going to just show you the gun and show you the preset, I'm going to also show you what is required for it, make it a little bit easier for you guys to build one of your own and try it out. But this is the stats, 72 ergo, 72 vertical recoil, pretty solid. Horizontal is pretty low too. And honestly, for the price, you really can't beat it. So without further ado, let's jump into what makes up my Beast Mode M1A. Now, these are the parts. We are actually gonna do it this way first. So if you've never seen these parts, some of these you might not have examined before, you might not have discovered, just look up the Magpul Gen 2 Front Sight FDE, the Hogue Overmold Rubber Grip FDE, Magpul Embus Gen 2 Rear Sight. Those are literally just for ergo. They don't do anything else. Colt A2 buffer tube, the NC Star backup mount, M14 30 round magazine, the Magpul PRS Gen 2 FDE stock, the Daniel Defense Wave muzzle brake, that's to mount the suppressor, the Belomo PK06, Fortis Shift tactical grip, 22 inch barrel. We're going with the longer barrel. I did run a shorter barrel for a little bit, but you don't have as many options for the muzzle if you do the shorter barrel. So I'm moving back to the long one. Then we also have the Troy SASS chassis stock for M14, the Sig Bravo 4x30 scope, and Daniel Defense Wave QD sound suppressor. Now all together, this gun comes to a whopping total of, at the moment, 279,000. So for the price, you really can't beat this thing. The stats, the way it looks, the way it sounds, the way it shoots, it's just a phenomenal gun. If you're into sniping, you like that long range, while also being able to play a little bit of short range with that PK06 backup, it's really just my favorite gun that I found so far. Did run a Hunter for a little bit, also messed around with some bolt actions, but I kind of just fell in love with the M1A. Almost have it mastered, actually. I think I'm almost level 3. Looking forward to having this mastered. So for those of you that do already have, let's say, everything examined and you want just this view, you can see right here, like the shift grip, the magazine. I do run the 30 instead of the 50 rounders. I ran the 50 rounders for a little bit. The only problem is that it kind of kills your ergo, for one, and for two, it makes it obviously a lot heavier. You saw the difference in the weight. But the biggest thing is that they got really expensive. For some reason, they just spiked up to being 50 grand, and I'm not spending 50K on a mag before I even put ammo in it. So I went back to the 30s. The 30s have always been pretty cheap. They're right around like 8,000 per mag. You just throw three of them in your tack rig and away you go. I wanted to keep this one short and sweet. Didn't want to take too much of your time. Just wanted to give you all the facts, give you the M1A, let you try it out for yourself. Let me know. I'm usually live on twitch.tv/Bams. Come tell me if you've tried it out, what you think of it. I'd love to hear your opinion. But until then, hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a thumbs up. I will catch you in the next one. Take it easy. Bams out.